स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स हैविंग रेड द फर्स्ट सेवन चैप्टर्स इन दिस टेक्स्ट बुक फ्लेमिंगो क्वाइट सक्सेसफुली नाउ वी शुड स्टार्ट लर्निंग द लास्ट चैप्टर चैप्टर नंबर 8 गोइंग प्लेसेस। डियर स्टूडेंट दिस द चैप्टर नंबर 8 इज रियली वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर एंड वी शुड टेक इट मोर इंटरेस्टिंगली। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल before we start reading the story as written by the author A.R. Barton here, we should start reading some important facts written about the author. As you can see here, the name of the author is A.R. Barton. A.R. Barton is a modern writer who lived in Zurich. Okay, A.R. Barton, who is a modern writer, lives in Zurich and writes in English. A.R. Barton always writes his books in English language only. In the story Going Places, Barton explores means bete discloses the theme of adolescent fantasizing and hero worship. Adolescent fantasizing stands for here the imaginations of an adolescent, a teenager, and hero worship stands for here a complete dedication or a complete attachment of a person to some other person. Okay, suppose a person is great fan of some highly profiled person, so we may call him hero worship. Okay, so it is known as a great lover and great fan of some important thing in life, some important person in life. So now this is the person A.R. Barton. Okay, this is the author A.R. Barton has written this the story especially based on the theme of the adolescent fantasizing and hero worship. Here are some expressions. Let's start getting the meaning of these all expressions first. Incongruity. Incongruity stands for a bit of inappropriateness, unsuitability. Okay, prodigy. The word prodigy stands for here highly distinguished quality man, highly distinguished quality person, a man or a person who has unmatched qualities is known as a prodigy. Chuffed, very pleased. The word chuffed stands for here very pleased. It will work here as an adjective. Chuffed means very pleased. Solitary elm stands for here. The word elm stands for here a kind of tree whose wood is very strong. Solitary stands for here lonely, where there is no other tree in its surrounding. So here the word solitary elm stands for here a kind of tree which grows in loneliness. Arcade. The word arcade stands for here a kind of passage, a kind of road, passage, place which is covered whether by the branches of long branches of trees or shops and buildings or roofs like this. Okay, a passage or a road or a street which is covered from both sides especially by the branches of trees or the shadows of high buildings and shops etc. It is known as arcade. हिंदी में छत्ता बोलते हैं वैसे इसको तो, लेकिन ये कोई इस प्रकार का स्थान होता है जहाँ पर छुपने के लिए काफ़ी पर्याप्त स्थान होता है, जहाँ पर चारों तरफ से बहुत ज़्यादा वो पेड़ों से या बिल्डिंग से इमारतों से वो जगह घिरी होती है, उसके लिए arcade लगाते हैं। एम्बर ग्लो स्टैंड्स फॉर हेयर डेजलिंग येलो कलर, जिसको बोलते हैं एम्बर ग्लो, डेजलिंग येलो कलर। वॉफ स्टैंड्स फॉर हेयर ए काइंड ऑफ प्लेटफॉर्म विच कैन बी सीन हेयर स्पेशली ऑन द साइड ऑफ द रिवर, ओके, और अ लेक ऑल्सो। पैंग्स ऑफ डाउट स्टैंड्स फॉर ए डाउटफुल सिचुएशन, suspected mood, fluctuating doubts in mind, doubts which continuously fluctuate in minds. Okay, no matter. Okay, let's start reading the story here. This is the first part of this chapter. When I leave, Sophie said, coming home from school. Coming home from school stands for here. After leaving school, or we may say on the way to her home after school. After leaving school, when Sophie started going back to her home, so she was on the way to her home. Having attended school, Sophie started coming back to her home with her friend Jency. So she spoke some words to her friend Jency, and the name of her friend is also already given here. So when I leave, Sophie said, coming home from school, I am going to have a boutique stands for here. I would like to open a boutique. Okay, the word boutique stands for here a kind of shop that sells the cosmetic items especially used by the women to adorn their beauty. So when I leave, Sophie said, coming home from school. It is the third time I am reading this statement. After school hours, when Sophie started coming back to her home, so on the way to her home, accompanied by her friend Jency, Sophie spoke these words. Sophie told her friend Jency about her dream, about her imagination, optical illusion, and she told her friend that as soon as she left the school, means as soon as she passed the last examination at a school, as soon as she qualified the last examination at a school, she would like to have a boutique. She would like to open her own boutique in her city. Jency, linking arms with her along the street, looked doubtful. Jency, who was walking along with Sophie, putting her arms into the arms of Sophie, or we may say, Jency, who was walking along the street with her friend Sophie, catching her arms, looked so doubtful. It means at that time, Jency looked really so much doubtful. She found herself in a highly suspected mood. When Jency heard the voice of her friend Sophie, she got badly confused and she looked totally suspected. She could hardly think that her friend Sophie could ever take such kind of dream in her life, because it was totally against her reach, out of her reach. It was not so easy for Sophie to open a boutique since she belonged to a poor family. Bete. Takes money, soft, something like that. Something like that stands for her opening such kind of or dealing in such kind of business of opening or boutique or selling the cosmetic items at a shop. Something like that stands for her having such kind of a shop. Opening such kind of a shop for you, okay? Opening such kind of a shop would really require a lot of money. Jency told Sophie that she would have to arrange a lot of money if she wanted to open a boutique. I will find it, Sophie said, staring far down the street. Okay, now casting her glance at the far end of the street, looking straight out on the street, Sophie told her friend Jency that she would manage the money to get her wish fulfilled. She would manage the money anyhow. It would be her duty. Take you a long time to save that much. Okay, she also suggested her friend Sophie that she would have to take a long time to save such a large amount of money to open a boutique. Well, I will be manager then. Yes, of course, to begin with, till I have got enough. But anyway, I know just how it's all going to look. Well, I will be manager then. So Sophie told her friend that there would be no matter of worrying, because as soon as she qualified the last examination, as soon as she qualified her examination at the school, she would like to get a job of company manager. As soon as she got the job of a company manager, she would like to save the money. And she knew it very well how it could be possible, because she had already decided so. But anyway, I know just how it's all going to look. And she also told Jensi that she knew it very well how much difficulty appeared before a person when he or she wanted to open a boutique, because it needed a lot of money. She was also well known to the fact. There was no need to give her any kind of advice in that especially in that case. She did not want to get her advice, bete. Sophie always considered herself more sincere, intelligent, knowledgeable than the other ones. That's why she did not take an interest in the words of her friend Jensi. Okay, they won't make you manager straight off, Soph. So attending her friend or calling the attention, not attending, calling the attention of her friend Sophie and calling her name, pet name, homely name, Soph. She told her that they would not like to appoint her directly at the post of a company manager. Okay, it could be possible that she could get a job, no matter, but it would not be possible for her to be the company manager directly after qualifying the examination. Okay, I will be like Mary Quant, Sophie said. I will be a natural. And Sophie, in response, Sophie told her friends Jensi that she would like to get the job of a company manager just like Mary Quant, who had already got the same job. I will be natural. And she also told it with her much conviction and belief that she would like to appear before the recruiting officers just like an ordinary person, and she would definitely impress them and get the job. They will see it from the start. They would like to check her nature and behavior as soon as she appeared before them, and they would definitely get themselves fully impressed to her personality. I will have the most amazing shop this city has ever seen. And then, having got herself appointed at the post of a company manager, she would like to open such kind of boutique in her town, which would be the first boutique, which would be the first shop the city would ever experience and seen in its life. Because she wanted to open a very different kind of shop there. Jensi, knowing they were both earmarked stands for a bit appropriate or suitable for the biscuit factory, became melancholy. Melancholy stands for thoughtfully sad and depressed, uncheerful. Jensi, knowing they were both earmarked for the biscuit factory. Jensi, who was really a realistic child, who knew it very well that they both could do work in a biscuit factory and not get any other higher position in their life, turned very serious, looked very sad and depressed when she came to know about the feelings of her friend. She wished Sophie won't say these things. She also thought that
She also took such kinds of ideas in mind that her friends hope she should not waste her time in such kinds of false stories, fake stories. When they reached Sophie's street, Jency said, "Oh, anyhow," they kept walking on the road, on the street, and when they reached Sophie's street, Sophie's street, Jency again told her, "It is only a few months now away now, Soph." It means only a very few months are still left in her hands to prepare herself for the examination, because she never studies hard, and she always wastes her time in her wild stories. That's why she would not be able to qualify the examination. So she said that it's only a few months away now. So you really should be sensible. Okay, you should be sensible. She also suggested her friend, saying it that she should not get herself confused every time. She should not keep herself fully lost in such kinds of optical illusions, because she should work as a realistic person, and she should always believe in practical works. They don't pay well for shop work. You know that. It means through this statement, Jency wanted to tell her friend Sophie Bete that she knew it very well that her family members could not pay her such a large amount of money which could help her open a boutique in the city, in the town. "Your dad would never allow it," she also told her, that her father would never permit her to open a boutique because he also lacked money. He also felt the shortage of money. Or an actress, but Sophie, ignoring all kinds of suggestions, advises, okay, such kinds of highly suggestive words. Sophie did not care for her friend's words, and she told her friend that if she could not be able to open a boutique, she would like to become an actress. Okay, now there is a real money in that. She also spoke these words with much conviction, with full confidence, saying that there was much money in the profession of acting. Okay, in the profession of acting in film shooting, and being an actress, she could earn a lot of money without any difficulty. "Yes, and I could maybe have the boutique on the side," she also told her friend that she could also open. She could also work on the boutique shop, apart from serving her duties, apart from paying her duties as an actress. Actresses don't work full times, do they? She told Jency. She also added that she knew it very well that, and she also knew it very well. Everybody knew it very well that actresses did not work all day long. They had so much time in their hand, they could start some additional work also in their daily life. In case she could not get success in becoming an actress, okay, or a fashion designer, you know, she convinced her friend, saying it that she would like to become a fashion designer, something a bit sophisticated, and that the profession of becoming a fashion designer was really very highly modernized, because it was the demand of time and it was really required by the modern people. It was a new profession and people liked it very much. That's why she would like to become a fashion designer. And she turned in through the open street door, leaving Jency standing in the rain. So by that time, Sophie's house had already appeared there. Okay, she had already got very near to the house, and she found that the main gate of her house was already open in the street, and she turned herself. She entered through the open street door, leaving her friend Jency outside the house, standing alone in the rain. Okay, she did not care for her friend, and she entered her house there without casting a glance at her. "If ever I come into money, I will buy a boutique." So by speaking these words, okay, while speaking these words, she entered the house, and when she appeared before her family members, at that time she was also speaking these words. She was saying something regarding her dream. If ever I come into money, whenever she would be able, she would be fortunate, she would find herself so much fortunate to earn so much money, she would like to buy a boutique. She spoke such kind of words, bete. Okay. So, the last word. If you ever come into money, you will buy us a blessed, decent house to live in. Thank you very much. When Sophie's father listened to her voice, he really took a sigh. He really took a long breath, and he contemptuously told Sophie that if whenever she found herself so much fortunate to earn so much money, so she would be very appreciated. She would be very lucky for them if she bought, instead of buying a boutique, if she bought a house for them, she would really be so much grateful to her, as they had no, good house, good conditioned house at that time to live in. So her father told her that they would really be so much thankful to her if she bought a house for them, for her family, okay, so that they could live in that house comfortably. But up to here, the first part completes. So now you should also revise the chapter on your part. Thank you, bete.